Truth is, we can't change the past. What's done is done. We gotta own our actions, but putting ourselves on trial, acting as our own judge, jury, and executioner, it's not the answer. Because a lot of the time, all that judging does is just ensure that we're gonna repeat the cycle. Right? We're not here to sit in judgment.
Why not?
The thing is, if you just do stuff and nothing happens, what's it all mean? What's the point? Oh, right, this whole thing is about self-acceptance.
Kicking the hell out of yourself doesn't give meaning to anything.
So I should stop judging and accept.
To start.
So no matter what I do, hooray for me because I'm a great guy. It's all good. No matter how many dogs I kill, I just would do an inventory and accept. I mean, you back your truck over your own kid and you like accept? What a load of crap.
Hey, Jesse, I know you're in pain.
No, you know what? Why I'm here in the first place is to sell you meth. You're nothing to me but customers. You okay with that? Huh? You accept?
No.
Let me give you a little inside information about God. God likes to watch. He's a prankster. Think about it. He gives man instincts. He gives you this extraordinary gift, and then what does he do? I swear, for his own amusement, his own private cosmic gag reel, he sets the rules in opposition. It's the goof of all time. Look, but don't touch. Touch, but don't taste. Taste, don't swallow. And while you're jumping from one foot to the next, what is he doing? He's laughing his sick fucking ass off. He's a tight ass. He's a sadist. He's an absentee landlord. Worship that, never.
Better to reign in hell than serve in heaven, is that it?
Why not? I'm here on the ground with my nose in it since the whole thing began. I've nurtured every sensation man has been inspired to have. I cared about what he wanted, and I never judged him. Why? Because I never rejected him. In spite of all his imperfections, I'm a fan of man. I'm a humanist. Maybe the last humanist. Who in their right mind, Kevin, could possibly deny the 20th century was entirely mine? All of it, Kevin! All of it. Mine. I'm peeking. It's my time now.
Well, we have no proof. All we have is this.
No. Oh. Wow, that's deep. So it's like life after birth. Hopeful. Right. What do you want? Why are you here? I've heard all of your platitudes. I got them, I know. She's in a better place. And this is all a part of a master plan. Heard that one too. Here's my favorite. God looked down and saw the most beautiful rose, so beautiful that he picked it to have it in heaven all for himself. Then there's the science, biocentrism, and we're all living and dying in infinite universes all at the same time. And then the religion, the Christians and their salvation, and the Buddhists and their samsara, and the Hindus and their 41st sacrament. And can't forget the poetry. Oh, the poetry. To die is different from what anyone supposed. And luckier, Whitman. And rage. Rage against the dying of the light. The wise men at their end know dark is right. Thomas,
and then row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. I got it. I got it. It all basically says that you're a natural part of life. We shouldn't hate you. We shouldn't fear you. I guess we should just accept you, right? That's it. I get it. Here's the thing. It's all a bunch of intellectual bullshit. She's not here holding my fucking hand.
To be or not to be, that is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of troubles, and by opposing, end them, to die, to sleep no more. And by a sleep to say we end the heartache thousand natural shocks that flesh is heir to. 'Tis a consummation devoutly to be wished. To die. To sleep. To sleep, a chance to dream. Aye. For in that sleep of death, what dreams may come when we have shuffled off this mortal coil must give us pause. There's the respect that makes calamity of so long life. For who would bear the whips and scorns of time, the oppressor's wrong, the proud man's contumely, the pangs of despised love, the law's delay, the insolence of office, and the spurns that patient merit of the unworthy takes. When he himself might his quietus make with a bare bodkin. Who would fardels bear to grunt and sweat under a weary life, but that the dread of something after death, the undiscovered country from whose bourne no traveller returns, puzzles the will and makes us rather bear those ills we have than fly to others that we know not of? Thus, conscience does make cowards of us all. And thus, the native hue of resolution is sicklied o'er with a pale cast of thought. And enterprises of great pitch and moment, with this regard, their currents turn awry and lose the name of action.
Now, where the hell do you go every day?
To the bathroom, sir.
To the bathroom. To the damn bathroom. For 40 minutes a day? What are you doing there?
We're T-minus zero here. I put a lot of faith in you.
There's no bathroom for me here.
What do you mean there's no bathroom for you here?
There is no bathroom. There are no colored bathrooms in this building or any building outside the West Campus, which is half a mile away. Did you know that? I have to walk to Timbuktu just to relieve myself. And I can't use one of the handy bikes. Picture that, Mr. Harrison. My uniform, skirt below my knees, my heels, and a simple string of pearls. Well, I don't own pearls. Lord knows you don't pay colors enough to afford pearls. And I work like a dog, day and night, living off a coffee from a pot none of you want to touch. So, excuse me if I have to go to the restroom a few times a day.
This is not a test. This is rock and roll. Time to rock it from the Delta to the DMZ. Is that me or does that sound like an Elvis Presley movie? Viva Da Nang. Oh, Viva Da Nang. Da Nang me, why don't they get a rope and hang me? Hey, is it a little too early for being that loud? Hey, too late. It's 0600. What's the O stand for? Oh, my God, it's early. Speaking of early, how about that Cro-Magnon Marty Drywitz? Thank you, Marty, for silky smooth sound. Make me sound like Peggy Lee. Freddie and the Dreamers.
Wrong speed. We've got it on the wrong speed. For those of you who are recovering from a hangover, that's going to sound just right.
Let's pull it right back down again. Let's try a little faster, see if that picks it up a little bit. Let's get up on 718. Those pilots are going right now. I really like the music. I really like the music. I really like the music. Oh, still a bad song.
Hey, wait a minute. Let's try something.
Let's play this backwards and see if it gets any better.
This new here, Freddy is a devil. This new here, Freddy is a devil.
Hey, hi, can you help me? What's your name? My name's Roosevelt Lee Roosevelt. Roosevelt, what town are you stationed in? I'm stationed in Poontang. Well, thank you, Roosevelt. What's the weather like out there? It's hot. Damn hot. Real hot. Hot in this is my shorts. I can cook things in it. Little crotch pot cooking. Well, can you tell me what it feels like? Fool, well, it's hot. I told you again. Were you born on the sun? It's damn hot. You can be a little thing. I saw it so damn hot. I saw one of those little guys in the orange robe burst into flames. It's that hot. You know what I'm talking about. What do you think it's going to be like tonight? It's going to be hot and wet. That's nice if you're with a lady, but it ain't no good if you're in the jungle. Thank you, Roosevelt. Here's a song coming your way right now. Nowhere to Run To by Martha and the Vandellas.
Yeah. To be Spider-Man.
Why?
Well, he knows a hero when he sees one. Too few characters out there flying around like that, saving old girls like me. And Lord knows, kids like Henry need a hero. Courageous, self-sacrificing people. Setting examples for all of us. Everybody loves a hero. People line up for them, cheer them, scream their names, and years later they'll tell how they stood in the rain for hours just to get a glimpse of the one who taught them to hold on a second longer. I believe there's a hero in all of us that keeps us honest, gives us strength, makes us noble. And finally allows us to die with pride. Even though sometimes we have to be steady and give up the thing we want the most. Even our dreams. Spider-Man did that for Henry, and he wonders where he's gone. He needs him.
I have had a lot of time, see, to think about what it is that makes somebody a good parent. And it's about a constancy, and it's about patience, and it's about listening. And it's about pretending to listen even when you can't listen anymore. And it's about love, like she said. See, Billy has a home with me, and I made it the best I could. And it's not perfect. And I'm not a perfect parent. And sometimes I don't have enough patience, and I forget he's just a little kid. But we built a life together, and we love each other. And if you destroy that, it'll be irreparable. Wait a minute.